तुम्हारे क्लास के बच्चे कम क्यों आ रहे, समझ नहीं आ रहे। 17 17 ओनली 17 आ गए। ओके
सो वी स्टार्ट वेव नेचर ऑफ लाइट आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट टू यू। This is what we call wave. Wave means we have crest and trough, or condensation and rarefaction. And this is another term. And this is medium at this center. So that is medium. Above it, there is one curve. Below it, another curve. Above curve is known under the name crest, and this is called trough. Crest, trough, in this way it will be moving. And wave nature generally indicate five characteristic properties. First property is wave length. It is represented by the symbol lambda. So what is wavelength? Wavelength is defined as distance between two consecutive crest or two consecutive trough. Means from this point to this point. This is the meaning of two consecutive crest. Two, therefore, it is the distance between two consecutive trough. This point and this point. So this is called the wavelength. Second property is frequency, represented by the symbol given. It is formed just like V, but it is not exactly V. And frequency mu. What is frequency? Frequency means number of full waves pass through a particular point in 1 second. Number of full wave. Full wave means one crest and one trough. Number of full waves pass through a particular point. In a particular point, how many waves are moving in 1 second? This is the meaning of frequency. Third property is velocity. Velocity is distance traveled by the wave in unit time. Distance traveled by the wave in unit time is called the velocity. It is in the case of light. It is represented by the symbol c. In other ways, when we consider a moving object, in that case v is the representation of velocity. But in the case of light, velocity is represented by the symbol c. Okay, now fourth property is amplitude, represented by the symbol A. Amplitude is represented by the symbol A. And what is amplitude? What amplitude is height of a crest or depth of a trough. Height means from the medium to this point. This is called height. Height of a crest or from this point to the medium. So this is also called the amplitude. This is amplitude, height of a crest or depth of a trough. And the last property is wave number. Wave number represented by the symbol mu bar, and it is the reciprocal of wavelength. That is, mu bar is equal to 1/2. These are the five characteristic property of a wave, and light is supposed to have wave nature. Therefore, light also possesses all these properties. Got it? Sachi, samajh mein aaya? Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now we will continue with the light. Last class we have discussed different type of sources of light.
There are two different sources of light. One is called a luminous source, another is non-luminous source. Luminous means the source of light. The light has its own. The source has its own light, like a sun, star, etc. Non-luminous means the object has no lights of its own. Perhaps it reflects the light from another source. Depends on light from another source, like moon. So this was the last topic we have discussed. Today we will discuss reflection of light in detail. The term reflection is known to you. Everybody knows. Okay. And the first part is just explain all the terminology behind the process reflection. Terminology. There are some typical words are there. So that we will discuss first. Then afterwards we will discuss the image formation of different type of mirrors and all. Okay. In between, maybe some of you know the definition also. Please keep quiet, because out of these 21 students, maybe some students don't know even angle of incidence, angle of reflection, very typical basic terms. Okay, so please take care of them. Maybe some of you know, maybe 50% of students know all these basic terms. Okay, you just listen. If you have any doubt, you can ask through chat box. Okay, so that we will have no problem, no disturbance in our class. I hope it is clear to every student. Okay, is it okay? Let us start our class with the definition. Good, very good. Agar bachche bhi aise respond karenge na, so I feel very good. Theek hai. So अब ऐसे नहीं, हम लोग अभी वर्चुअल क्लास में, लेकिन मुझे हमेशा फील होता है तुम लोग सब एक एक बेंच में बैठे मेरे सामने. ठीक है, सो जो बच्चों को मैं जानती हूँ वो बच्चे मेरे सामने बैठे हैं, सो आई हैव नो प्रॉब्लम एट ऑल. तुम लोग सब कोई भी अपने वीडियो में नहीं आते, हो सकते नेटवर्क इश्यूज है. हाँ, मानती हूँ इफ आई हैव, इफ यू हैव सम बोर्ड वर्क, इफ नेटवर्क इश्यू इज देयर, सो इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट. So it's okay. I am also not compelling you to come in video. Okay. So let us start. First of all, what is reflection? The process of sending back the light rays which falls on surface of the object is called a reflection. The process of sending back of the light rays which fall on surface of any object. When light falls on any particular object, when it is sent back, it is not necessarily sent back to the same source. When it is sent back, it is known under the name reflection. Okay, and then let us think about, there are different type of object, and it is not necessary that all cases the reflection will be perfect. The object having polished the shining appearance. Polished, you know that, for example, what we say, metals, silver metal. You can see that it is highly polished the surface. Silver metal, gold metal, these all. So when light falls on these object, the light will be reflected. Reflected to maximum extent. Understood? So that means more light is reflected from a polished surface. Like metal surface, like not all metals, like silver, gold, etc. Or simply plain mirror. When light fall on plain mirror, it also reflect. So this is the first case where light fall on polished. And another case, when light falls on a other case, I will tell you one example. If light falls on a paper, is maximum reflection takes place or not? Paper, on a paper. What do you think?
It has,
no, it has uneven surface. Ah, very good. It has uneven surface, isn't it? uneven surface. So maximum reflection will not take place. Okay, so this is all about the general idea regarding reflection. Now regarding reflection, let us think about five definitions. Okay, first of all, we can think about a ray of light and a bundle of light. What do you mean by ray? Single one ray is there, so it is called a ray of light. When at a time there are many lines, bundle means a bunch of light. Lines of light are moving. Bunch means one arrow, then another arrow, and another. In this way, if it is coming a bunch, then the terminology used is beam of light. Single line means a ray of light. Or if more than one ray is there, so it is known under the name beam of light. Beam. B-E-A-M. Got it? So you just note down the terms at least. A ray of light and a beam of light. Both are different. Like a ray is singular. Wait. Ray of light means a single ray is there, and beam of light means more than one ray is there. So got it? This is the first thing. Second is incident ray. What do you mean by incident ray? A ray of light which falls on the mirror surface. Which falls on the mirror surface is called a incident ray. Mirror surface. If you are interested, I will draw the picture. Suppose this is mirror surface. Ye ulta bana leti rahega. This is plane. This is for this particular picture. I can utilize for different purpose. That's why. So this is a mirror and ray of light which is falling on this mirror is called as falling. So see the direction. This is the way we can represent it. This ray is called the incident ray. At least you can also draw this diagram and label every turns in the diagram. Okay, and this is mirror. Okay, this is called incident ray. After falling on the mirror surface, so it is sending more lights because it is mirror. And then this reflected ray means from the mirror to the same surface. Okay, the ray of light which is sent back to by the mirror. The ray of light which is sent back by the mirror is called the reflected ray. Okay, then you can see that this incident ray falls on one particular point. This point is said to be point of incidence. Point of incidence. Okay, so this is the preliminary things related to reflection. Now come to the next term, norm. See that I am drawing a line which is perpendicular to the mirror. So that means like this. Okay, normally it is not by using solid light. So you can use and this line is perpendicular to the plane. and it is starting from the point of incidence. This line is said to be normal. Okay, normal. Now, these are the terms related to incident ray, reflected ray, point of incident, normal. Now we have, you can see two angles are there. One angle made by the incident ray with the normal, this one. This angle is called the angle of incidence. And you can represent it by the symbol I means incidence. So the angle which is formed between incident ray and the normal is said to be angle of incidence. Got it? Angle of incidence. It is the angle made by the incident ray with the normal at the point of incidence. That's important. At the point of incidence is called the angle of incidence. Now you can see one more angle like this. This is the angle made by the reflected ray with the normal at the point of incidence. And this is said to be angle of reflection. Reflection word start with the alphabet R. Therefore, this is represented by R. So, you can understand this diagram. You need to be aware of all the terms which I have labeled in the diagram. So, this is the basic thing related to this chapter. Okay. Got it? Draw the diagram. If you have drawn, then you can write Y on the chapters. Drawn means you label it also. Okay. Draw it, label it. Ha, very good. Sachi, Kartike, Mitushi, Tanya, Ashna, Pujita. Yes, itni bachi complete kiya hai. Baki bachi ka hai? Mehek. Sakshi, Anmol, Vetika, Anjan. Good. Very good. Chalo, abhi main isko mita rahi hu. Ha, Jatin. Ab aage? Very good. So, now I will discuss another topic. It is on the basis of this diagram only. Okay. What is that? Loss of reflection of light. You can write the heading. Laws of reflection of light. There are two laws known under the name laws of reflection. First law is the incident ray, the reflected ray, and the normal all lie in the same plane. Which are lying in the same plane? First law suggested that or states that the incident ray. Then reflected ray and the normal. These all three are lying in the same plane. Got it? This is the first part. And what is the second part? Angle of reflection is always equal to angle of incidence. Angle of reflection is always, or you can write like this, angle of reflection is always equal to angle of incidence, or we can say that angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So these are the two parts of laws of reflection, very very important. Got it? So these are the two parts you have to. This is also known under the name Snell's law, SNE double LS. Second part is also called a Snell's law. Now, I will ask one question. What happens when a ray of light falls normally? Normally means what? परपेंडिकुलर टू दी सरफेस ऑफ दी बॉडी
मैम वो उसी पाथ पे वापस रिफ्लेक्ट हो जाएगा
भाई मैम 180 डिग्री रिफ्लेक्शन
हां गुड व्हेन एनी रे ऑफ लाइट falls normally or perpendicular to the surface of the plane means जो normal के through जो light incident हो रहा है तो वो light reflection की बात कहाँ जाएगा और क्या होगा वो light वो ray of light answer is it is reflected back along the same path how can you prove that because angle I is equal to angle R What is angle I is equal to angle R? That's why we can say that when a ray of light falls normally or perpendicular to the surface of the mirror, it reflected back. Okay, so this is all about the law. Now let us think about the second part. When we are considering reflection. There are two types of reflections are there. What is called the angular reflection? Our second is called the diffused reflection. Regular reflection and diffused reflection. What do you mean by regular reflection? In a regular reflection, beam of incident light reflected as a parallel beam in one direction. I will show you. See, beam of light means what? More than one ray of light. Whenever you draw any ray diagram, you need to show the direction. Okay, these all are this is a bunch of incident rays, bunch of incident ray known under the name beam of light. Okay, see that this beam of light incident on a mirror, then what will happen? See that it reflects the same. You can see that it is reflected in a same pattern, isn't it? Same pattern. जैसे वो reflect की right, जैसे वो आगे है, वैसे वो reflect करती है. This type of reflection is called a regular reflection. And remember, regular reflection always takes place in smooth surface. Regular. What is definition चाहिए क्या? लिखा in regular reflection, a parallel beam of incident light is reflected as a parallel beam. Reflected as a parallel beam in one direction. Parallel beam in one direction. Got it? This is the definition of okay. Means जैसे वो आ गया, वैसे ही वो वापस चले जाते हैं. इसी type की reflection को बोलते हैं regular reflection. ठीक है? अब मैं सेकेंड टाइप का बताती हूँ डिफ्यूज्ड रिफ्लेक्शन क्या होती है मैं आपको पहले एक ड्राइंग बना देती हूँ ठीक है और उसके बाद एक्सप्लेन करूंगी ठीक है जैसे देखो मैं ये प्लेन मिरर नहीं है दिस इज कॉल्ड द रफ सरफेस मुझे इतना बनाने नहीं आते बट कोशिश की मैंने Again, beam of light is coming. देखो, beam आ रहा है.
इस तरह से बीम ऑफ लाइट आ रहा है, लेकिन देखो बिकॉज ऑफ दिस अनइवन नेचर ऑफ द सरफेस क्या होता है, ये इधर आएगा और इसमें से एक इधर चले जाएगा और ये इधर चले जाएगा और ये सी रिफ्लेक्टेड रे इज नॉट रिफ्लेक्टेड इन द सेम डायरेक्शन, ठीक है, इट इज इन डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन, इट इज नॉट इन सिंगल डायरेक्शन। प्रीवियस पिक्चर देखो, जैसे वो बीम जैसे आया वैसे ही वो वापस गया रिफ्लेक्टेड, ठीक है, लेकिन इसमें देखो एक फोर रे ऑफ लाइट, दैट मींस बीम ऑफ लाइट आ गया, लेकिन ये कैसे रिफ्लेक्ट हो रहे, लुक एक इधर गया और दूसरा इधर गया, तीसरा इस साइड गया और चौथा इस साइड गया, ठीक है, दैट मींस दे रिफ्लेक्टेड इन डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन। दिस काइंड ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन इज कॉल्ड द डिफ्यूज्ड रिफ्लेक्शन। चाहे तो आप नोट करो डेफिनेशन, इन डिफ्यूज्ड रिफ्लेक्शन, इन डिफ्यूज्ड रिफ्लेक्शन पैरेलल बीम ऑफ इंसिडेंट लाइट इज रिफ्लेक्टेड इन different directions, reflected in different directions, ठीक है, तो ये आपको ध्यान रखना है। और एग्जाम्पल आप ये लिख सकते हैं, रिफ्लेक्शन ऑन कार्डबोर्ड, रिफ्लेक्शन ऑन चेयर, रिफ्लेक्शन ऑन वॉल दीवार, दीज ऑल आर द सर्फेसेस वेयर द सर्फेस इज अनइवन, where or even a sheet of paper, which kind of reflection takes place, diffused reflection takes place, okay, this is all about the type of reflection. Now I will discuss a little different terms, maybe it is known to you. When we are considering reflection, whenever we draw a diagram, so we must have an object and we must get a image, mirror image, isn't it? So what is an object? Anything which gives out light is called an object. ये जरूरी नहीं है अपनी लाइट हो और कहीं से वो रिफ्लेक्ट हो गए लाइट, ये जरूरी नहीं है, कंडीशन ये है कि एनीथिंग विच गिवस आउट लाइट इज कॉल्ड एन ऑब्जेक्ट, ये भी लिख लो, एनीथिंग विच गिव्स आउट लाइट अपना है या रिफ्लेक्टेड लाइट और दूसरी सोर्स से है, ये दोनों को हम बता सकते हैं, क्या बता सकते हो, ऑब्जेक्ट, ठीक है। नेक्स्ट, व्हाट इज एन इमेज, इमेज इज एन ऑप्टिकल अपीयरेंस प्रोड्यूस्ड व्हेन लाइट रेज कमिंग फ्रॉम द ऑब्जेक्ट are reflected from a mirror. Optical appearance मतलब आपको देखने के लिए क्या मिलते हैं ऑब्जेक्ट का, ठीक है, इट इज एन ऑप्टिकल अपियरेंस, ऑप्टिकल अपियरेंस मीन्स आपको क्या ऑब्जेक्ट में से आपको क्या रिजल्ट मिला है, इट इज कॉल्ड ऑप्टिकल अपियरेंस। हाँ, डेफिनेशन में पहले समझाऊंगी कर, ठीक है, उसके बाद में कर दूंगी, ठीक है। So image is an optical appearance produced when light rays coming from an object are reflected from a mirror. जो reflected rays आते हो ना object से जो आते हैं reflected rays, उसी के help से जो optical appearance बन रहा है वही optical appearance को बोलते हैं image, ठीक है। अब लिख लो इमेज क्या है, व्हाट इज एन इमेज, इमेज इज एन ऑप्टिकल अपीयरेंस प्रोड्यूस्ड व्हेन लाइट रेज कमिंग फ्रॉम एन ऑब्जेक्ट आर
ऑब्जेक्ट आर रिफ्लेक्टेड फ्रॉम अ मिरर, रिफ्लेक्टेड फ्रॉम अ मिरर। ठीक है, अब अपनी लाइफ में से एक एग्जाम्पल बताओ। आपने आईने में देखते हैं, इमेज मिल रहे हैं यार, ओरिजिनल मिल रहे, बताओ। हम मिरर में देखते हैं, अपनी ओरिजिनल मतलब मिल रहे हैं या एक इमेज मिल रहा है, बताओ।
इमेज, इमेज।
और एक एग्जाम्पल बताओ अपनी लाइफ में से। हाँ, वेरी गुड। और अपनी लाइफ से बताओ और कुछ एग्जाम्पल वेयर इमेज आपको मिलते हैं, ओरिजिनल नहीं, बताओ। फोन पे, हाँ ठीक है, फोन पे, और वेरी गुड। और अभी तो फोन पे है क्योंकि वो सिनेमा हॉल में नहीं जा सकते, वाटर में। हाँ, सिनेमा हॉल में जो मिलते हैं ना, हाँ वेरी गुड, कैमरा वाला, हाँ वेरी गुड, हाँ ठीक है, ऑल आर करेक्ट। ठीक है, ये सब को हम बोलते हैं इमेज। अब नाउ इमेज इज क्लासिफाइड इनटू टू कैटेगरी। ठीक है, एक नकली है, एक असली है, मींस रियल
इमेज एंड वर्चुअल
इमेज एंड वर्चुअल इमेज। सिंपल डिफरेंस है, सिंपल डिफरेंस विच वी कैन कॉटेड ऑन ए स्क्रीन, कैच ऑन ए स्क्रीन, इट इज कॉल्ड अ रियल। ठीक है, जैसे हम लोग मिरर में देखते हैं, हमें रियल मिल रहे या कुछ नकली मिल रहे, असली मिल रहे,
रियल इमेज,
रियल इमेज मिल रहे।
नहीं मैम, नहीं मैम, वर्चुअल, क्योंकि वो इरेक्ट होता है,
वहां पे स्क्रीन में नहीं आते हो ना, इसीलिए। बट सिनेमा हॉल में जो इमेज मिल रहा है वो क्या है, वो रियल है या वर्चुअल? वो रियल, वेरी गुड, क्योंकि सिनेमा हॉल में हम देख रहे हैं ना, तो ओरिजिनल एक्ट्रेस ने किया है, वो स्क्रीन पे आ रहा है। सही है, सही है कि नहीं, बताओ। अरे एक तो बच्चे बताओ, कार्तिक,
लेकिन वो तो इरेक्ट रहता है।
नहीं नहीं, मैंने क्वेश्चन पूछे कि सिनेमा हॉल में जो हम इमेज दिख रहे हैं, तो एक्ट्रेस की, तो हीरो हीरोइन की, वो रियल है वर्चुअल, ये बता रहे। वो स्क्रीन में आ गए ना, जो भी स्क्रीन में आ रहे हैं उसको हम रियल बोलते हैं। ठीक है, लेकिन हम मिरर के सामने हम खड़े होता है, हमारे इमेज स्क्रीन में थोड़ी ना आता है। हाँ, कैप्चर्ड इन स्क्रीन, वेरी गुड। अब वर्चुअल इमेज स्क्रीन में नहीं आ रहा है। ठीक है, आगे कंटिन्यू करेंगे अगले क्लास में। मैंने आपसे प्रॉमिस किया था मैं एक एक्सपेरिमेंट दिखाऊंगी। इतनी जो बेसिक बेसिक जो टर्म्स है, इसकी डेफिनेशन प्लीज आज पढ़िए, और आपको एक दिन की गैप मिल रहे हैं, इसी गैप में प्लीज आप इसको पढ़ लो, और मैं परसों पूछूंगी, नाम लेके पूछूंगी। ठीक है, डराना नहीं, डराती हूँ नहीं मैं। ठीक है, लेकिन प्लीज आप पढ़ लीजिए। ठीक है, मैं प्रेजेंट करती हूँ एक, मुझे मैंने आपको बता दिया था। अभी दिख रहे हो ना, ओ लैब्स दिख रहे हो, कोई बच्चे बताओ दिख रहे हो इसका? मैं देखो थियरी बता रही, इधर देखो थियरी लिख रहे, मेटल्स आर एलिमेंट्स आर गुड कंडक्टर्स, ये सब थियरी नहीं बता रही मैं, सिर्फ आपको ये वीडियो दिखा दूंगी। ठीक है, देख, यू कैन रीड इट, ऑल द मेटल सॉल्ट सॉल्यूशन, कॉपर सल्फेट, जिंक सल्फेट, AgNO3, एंड ऑल, दिख रहे हो ना?
Related reactivity of metals. Some metals react more easily than others. A reactive metal is one that readily reacts with other elements.
क्या प्रॉब्लम हो रहे
हैं? अच्छा, मैम आपके दोनों माइक ऑन थे।
अच्छा जी, ठीक है, मैं
from its salt solution. that does not lose its electrons easily. The most reactive metals will react even with water, while the least reactive will not react even with concentrated acid. Displacement reactions, which are very common in metals, can be used to find out the relative reactivities of metals. In this reaction, a more reactive metal displaces a less reactive metal from its salt solution. In the order of reactivity from the highest to the lowest, metals are arranged in a reactivity series or activity series, which is used to summarize information about the reactions of metals with acid and water, single displacement reactions, and the extraction of metals from their ores. In this experiment, our aim is to observe the action of iron, copper, zinc, and magnesium on the solutions of copper sulfate, zinc sulfate, aluminium sulfate, and silver nitrate, and arrange them in the order of reactivity based on the results observed. Materials required: small pieces of iron, copper, zinc, magnesium, aqueous solution of copper sulfate, zinc sulfate, aluminium sulfate, and silver nitrate. Procedure: to test the reactivity of iron in the solution of copper sulfate, zinc sulfate, and aluminium sulfate, take small pieces of iron and put them into the beakers containing copper sulfate, zinc sulfate, and aluminium sulfate solutions. Leave the beakers undisturbed for one day. After a day, the color of copper sulfate solution turns from blue to light green, and red-brown particles of copper settle at the bottom of the beaker. This indicates that iron is more reactive than copper, as Fe2 plus ions displace Cu2 plus ions from copper sulfate solution. In the other two cases, there is no change observed. This indicates that iron is less reactive than the other two metals, aluminium and zinc, so it cannot displace these metals from their salt solutions. To test the reactivity of copper in solutions of silver nitrate, aluminium sulfate, and zinc sulfate, add pieces of copper into the silver nitrate, aluminium sulfate, and zinc sulfate solutions. After a day, the colorless silver nitrate solution changes to blue-colored copper nitrate solution, and silver particles settle down at the bottom of the beaker. Here, copper is more reactive than silver, so it displaces silver from silver nitrate solution. In the other two cases, since copper is less reactive than aluminium and zinc, there are no changes observed in their salt solutions. To test the reactivity of zinc in the solutions of copper sulfate, aluminium sulfate, and silver nitrate, take small pieces of zinc and add them in the beakers containing these salt solutions. After a day, we can observe that red-brown particles of copper settle down at the bottom of the copper sulfate solution. This indicates that zinc is more reactive than copper, and it displaces copper from the copper sulfate solution to form zinc sulfate. In the case of silver nitrate, since zinc is more reactive than silver, it displaces silver from silver nitrate solution, and particles of silver settle down at the bottom of the beaker. But in the case of aluminium sulfate, no change is observed, as zinc is less reactive than aluminium. So zinc cannot displace aluminium from aluminium sulfate solution. To test the reactivity of magnesium in the solutions of copper sulfate, silver nitrate, and zinc sulfate, add small pieces of magnesium into the beakers containing these solutions and leave them undisturbed for one day. After a day, we can observe that copper, zinc, and silver particles settle down at the bottom of the beaker containing the respective solutions. This indicates that magnesium is more reactive than copper, zinc, and silver. So it displaces copper from copper sulfate solution, zinc from zinc sulfate solution, and silver from silver nitrate solution. From these reactions, we can infer that iron displaces copper, zinc displaces copper and silver, and magnesium displaces zinc, copper, and silver. So magnesium